according. We have two variables x and y. Suppose if I just change any one of the variable, maybe x or maybe y. Okay, I am just increasing it. I'm increasing the value of x. Suppose corresponding to that, if y is either increasing or decreasing. Okay, as there is some change in the value of x, suppose there is correspondingly, there is change in the value of y, then isn't it there is some relation between these two variables? Yes? Okay, just suppose if I have some function f of x is equal to 2. And I have a function f of x is equal to, or else y is equal to f of x, which is equal to some x square. I go on changing the value of x. Tell me, corresponding to this, there will be a change in the value of y, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Surely. For this first function, I go on changing the value of x. Is y is going to change?
No.
No, ma'am.
It will not change, right? So there may be some possibility that here it may change or it may not change. Two possibilities are there. Correct. So if there is some change, if whenever you change one variable, maybe increasing or decreasing, correspondingly the other variable may increase or decrease. So isn't it they are related? Agree? I don't know what is the function, but isn't it we can say that they both are related, right?
Yes.
So here, they are related. This is called as correlation. So we say that the variables x and y are correlated. Are you getting the concept? So this is what is the next part of module 4, that is correlation and regression. About regression, we'll take little later on, because the concept correlation is first has to be studied. See, this is very easy concept. And much of the thing are like, there are some 2-3 standard problems are there. Otherwise, other all problems are like on calculation based. So easily you can solve it. So when can you say that the two variables are related? If change in one is resulting into change in the other variable. Okay. Now suppose I have two variables which are related. Now here, suppose if I increase the value of x, corresponding to this, suppose y also increases, or I decrease the value of x, corresponding to this, suppose the value of y also decreases. Are you getting the thing? Increase will give me increase and decrease may give me decrease. That time, so tell me first, thing, are they correlated, yes or no, if this is a situation?
Yes, no.
Yes. See, there is a change. There is a change. Correct. Now, increase will give me increase. Decrease will give me decrease means we say that they are positively correlated. Okay? The correlation is called as positive correlation. Similarly, what may happen? X, suppose you are increasing the value of x, corresponding to this, suppose y is decreasing. And you are decreasing the value of x, corresponding to this, the value of y is increasing. I'm talking of each of the value, huh? It's set of values. So here, just see, increase will give me decrease, and decrease will give me increase. Can anybody tell me what is this called as then?
Negative
correlation, and the variables are called as negatively correlated. Okay, now suppose if I'm increasing the value of x for some set of values, maybe some 10 values. 10 values I'm taking, I'm just go on increasing the values. Corresponding to this for y, sometimes like maybe for 5 values or some 4 values, it may increase. for remaining some six values, it may decrease. Okay, I'm just go on increasing the values, but here y value increases and then decreases. So can you say, is there, are they correlated?
No, ma'am.
Obviously, there is no relation. Okay, there is no proper relation between them. So they are called as, okay, it is called as non-correlation. Okay, it is called as non-correlation. Or they are uncorrelated. Okay, I'll take one example. Okay, now it's a mango season. Let me take an example of that only. So suppose here in the beginning, no? In the beginning, suppose now the, okay, when the starting of the season, what will be the cost of mango? Is it going to be more or less? Very high, right? Very high, correct? So that time here, you have a number of like the fruit available is less, correct? But here that time the cost will be more. The quantity, you can say the quantity is less and cost is more. Similarly, when the like after some 1 month or so, what happens? The quantity increases. So what happens to the price or the cost?
Decreases.
Obviously, it decreases, right? Okay. So here, now if I want to just tell about me this quantity and this cost, okay. So can you tell me, are they related, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, how they are related, positively or negatively or uncorrelated will not come here. They are negatively correlated. Correct. Increase in one corresponds to the decrease in the other. Suppose there is one particular type of mango is there, okay, of high quality. You can take mango or anything. So suppose here the demand is more. If we have a demand is more, then what happens to the price? Is it going to increase or decrease?
Increase, ma'am.
Obviously, it will increase. Don't take the example of only mango. You can take any of the, you can say anything, right? So whenever there is a demand is more, obviously the price of that product will be always goes on increasing, correct? So they are what now? They are correlated, but how?
Positively.
Positively. They are positively correlated. Now, if I give an example that, see, today there may, it may rain. That's why the price of the mango is going to be high or low. If I say like that, is it true?
No, ma'am.
Today, lot of rain is there. So here, rain is more. So what happens to the price? Increases or decreases? We can't say about it, right? Depends. They don't change the price according to the rain. So they are not at all related, isn't it? Huh? If it is a hot day, right? Price of the mango will be more or less. No. So what is this called as? These two things are correlated. They are not correlated, uncorrelated. Okay. This is about like some background regarding correlation and all. Not to worry, because we have to stick on to the examples. How to solve the example is very, very important. But don't say only here that it will be always y is a function of x. It may be x may be also a function of y, whatever it is. There are two different variables are there. If they are related, there is a correlation. If they are not related, they are uncorrelated. Okay. So usually we have some like scatter diagram. They give it in the form of a scatter diagram or called as dot diagram. which indicates positive, negative correlation and all. So there was lot of theory behind this, but for your syllabus, you have to just study how to solve example related to this. Okay, now see, I gave some example, mango, rain, price, demand, okay, supply, everything I give. Now here, suppose here I have a set of values given as X and Y. I don't know what this stands for, correct? So I have a set of values of X and Y given in the form of a table. I want to see whether these two are related, yes or no. Okay, so there should be some measurement for that, isn't it? I need to get whether they are related, yes or no. So that measurement or that can be calculated by using coefficient of correlation. And it is denoted as R. It is called as Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Okay, so to calculate the relation between two variables, we use the concept coefficient of correlation, which is denoted as R. This is called as Karl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Okay, because sometimes they mention this name, you should be aware. It is denoted as small r. Now here this value of R, this is given by some formula. This is summation xy divided by square root of summation of x square into summation of y square. Now here just see, these are small x and y values given. I'm using the formula capital XY, isn't it? Okay. So here, this capital X is nothing but small x minus x bar, and capital Y is nothing but y minus y bar. Can anybody tell me what is this x bar and y bar used to denote? Usually, you might have come across this. Anybody? X bar, y bar. No, no idea. See, they have given the set of values of x here and set of values of y here, right? X bar is nothing but the mean of the x values. How to get the mean? How can I get the mean of x values? Mean or average? You don't know how to calculate mean?
I'm divided by number of...
divided by upper part, what is there?
Summation of x.
X bar is summation of x divided by a half part x. Angle, half part, one more. Tell, complete.
Mom, and...
N. What is this? N is the number of values. So go on adding all the x values divided by number of values. Similarly, what will be y bar then?
Yeah, summation of y by n.
Summation y by n. Add all the y values divided by n. This is called as mean and all. See, if I want to get the mean of your class, okay, they ask the average of your class, suppose. Then what I do usually, do you aware of this? Maybe not. I add the marks of all the students, those like out of 50, all the marks divided by number of students. That will give me the mean of your class. Mean marks of this first IA, suppose, if I want to calculate. Okay. So is it that means that everybody has got that marks? try to just
no, ma'am.
Understand the statistical part of this. Huh? No, it is not like everybody. Suppose the class average is some 45. Is it all students have got 45?
No, ma'am.
No. Ma'am. One more thing will come. This is very important. Some students don't have any idea regarding this. See, average means here what we do, we add all the marks divided by number of students. This will give me the average. So if this is good, then I can say the class is average class. If it is less, no, then I have to say the class performance is not that good enough. Okay. It even depends on one more quantity called as standard deviation. Anybody has any idea regarding what is standard deviation? I think you learned this in school, I guess, statistical part. Do you know actual what is standard deviation means? No? Okay. Calculation wise and all, we'll do it. Okay. Standard deviation is given by summation of x minus x bar the whole square divided by n and all that. But actually standard deviation stands for, suppose my class average is something like 45. Huh? Now, if suppose the students who have got the marks range like 40 to 50. If my students, okay, for the whole class have got 40 to 50, standard deviation will be less. Okay. Suppose if my class average is some 40 and students have got from 0 to 50 marks. Okay. Maybe some have got some one digit number, some have got 20s, some have got in 30s, and some have got 40s and maybe 50. So that time my standard deviation will be more. It's a deviation. What is a deviation from the mean that we calculate? So if here, now for first I, you can observe that many students have got good marks, isn't it? Many have got 50, 49 and all that. So this time, surely my standard deviation for the class will be very less. Got it? That only if I want to calculate, suppose for other, okay, where maybe they might have got some one digit number starting from this. So this range is more, 0 to 50 is very more. So that time standard deviation will be more. This idea you should have actually. Okay, let it be. So this is the formula to calculate R. Is the part clear? What they will do? They'll give X and Y. Okay, first you calculate X bar and Y bar. You know, this is the formula. Now, after that, you construct one tabular form containing capital X, which is X minus X bar, and Y is Y minus Y bar. For each value of X, you take its difference from the mean. Okay, this X bar and Y bar will be fixed. Take, construct that X and Y, and then later on, you just see this. What are the other columns required? See this formula and tell me, what are the other things required? I want to calculate R.
Y square, Y square.
Yeah, I want X into Y. I want X square. I want Y square. Do just, form the column for that. Add the values, you'll get summation. Substitute in this formula, you'll get the value of R. One more thing, R, the value of R is between minus 1 to plus 1 only. Suppose by calculation for any example, if you are exceeding the value after 1 or maybe less than minus 1, your answer is 100% wrong. Are you getting it? The value of R is always between minus 1 to plus 1. Can anybody tell me if I get R as some negative value, what that indicates? What that indicates?
Negatively correlated.
They are negatively correlated. And if I get it as 1, okay, positive value, they are positively correlated, isn't it? Now, one more important thing is, suppose a value is very, very nearer to 1. Can anybody tell me? The correlation is more stronger actually. This is very useful in the higher part when you do some projects and all, no? If you want to get like some experiment is done, whether these things are related or no, correct? That you want to calculate, no, you can use the help. You can take the help of this coefficient of correlation. See, you are, suppose you are having some problem where you want to see what are the things which are being affected, what are the external things affected for that particular thing, right? Some problem is there, correct? there may be some, okay, for example, crack in the building. So that crack in the building will be affected by so many factors, whether they are related to this positively, negatively, or how strong they are related, you can calculate with the help of this. Are you getting some idea now? Say yes or no.
Yes,
ma'am.
Related be. Okay, yeah. So this is what is the thing. So hope you, just write down the formula R equal to, and just write the note R is between minus 1 to plus 1. R can also be calculated by one more formula that we'll use very rarely. So this is sigma square x plus sigma square y minus sigma square x minus y divided by 2 sigma x and sigma y, where sigma square x is nothing but sigma x is standard deviation of x series. Okay, sigma square x is variance actually. Sigma, only if you take sigma x, it is a standard deviation. This is summation of x minus x bar the whole square divided by n. Okay, this is sigma square x. Now this formula we'll use little later on, but time being, when the question is only related to correlation, this is what we have to use it. Okay, now, yeah. Do you know what is the relation between variance and standard deviation? Anybody? Standard deviation is square root of variance. Here, that, and sigma x is standard deviation. Okay, shall I take example now? Have you written this part? I take an example from your model question paper only. Right. The following are. Okay. Write the value formula for R. Just indicate what these are.
Ma'am, what's the formula for standard deviation?
You see, we have a table where they have given the marks of 8 students scored in 2 different subjects. Okay, so they have given it. So marks in statistics and marks in mathematics, they want us to calculate the rank correlation coefficient. That means we need to calculate R. So here, after calculation of R, they want to know whether they are related, yes or no. Because if statistics is good, whether the same student can perform well in mathematics, yes or no. Okay, this is what they want to know. We'll not give all any conclusion. We'll just calculate the rank correlation coefficient. Okay, so what do? Take marks in statistics as some variable.
X.
So let marks in statistics as X and marks in mathematics as Y. Okay. Then what we'll do, we'll just calculate first x bar and y bar. Okay, the x bar is nothing but summation of x divided by n. Now, summation of x, see, don't prepare again one more table where again you are going to write these values because already it is there. What, for what it is required, we'll construct the table. So here, what you have to do, add all the values of this marks in statistics. Yeah, start, as this is first example, I'll write in detail. This is 25 plus 43 plus 27 plus 35. Isn't it? This is how we have to take summation of x. 54, 61, 37, 45. Divided by how many set of values are there? There are 8, correct? Because they have given the marks for 8 students. Yeah. Add it and divide by 8. Tell me the answer. Else, tell me the addition.
41.
Huh?
324, ma'am.
324. Values take them correctly, yes, ma'am. Sure?
No, yes, ma'am. It's correct. Yes, ma'am. Sure.
All of you do the calculation once again.
Ma'am, 327.
See, Spandana, you might have written one value wrong. Maybe. That chance is there.
327.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am. It's
major.
Yeah, that's what. One digit, no, if you wrongly take, it is obviously going to happen. Is it 40.87?
875.
875. Okay, 875. Let it be. So then what we'll do? I'm just thinking whether we'll round it off or what, because this is very nearer to 41. If I take like this, the values will be in decimals, isn't it? Huh? Better we'll round it off. Take it. 40.875 is nearer to what value?
Ma'am,
41,
obviously. Okay, so this is my X bar. Otherwise, what happens? No, this we have to take now x minus x bar, like 25 minus 40.875, and then we have to calculate. So it will be little problematic. This is very nearer to 41. Better take it. Now tell me now, we have to calculate what is y bar. Y bar is summation of y divided by n. Again, add all the values. You know now how to take it.
324.
You complete that part. 324.
Yeah.
No, ma'am.
Majority 324. What is the answer then? 40.5. Okay, let it. We will not round it off. We'll not take 41 and all. We'll keep 40.5. Is not that problematic. Take it as it is. This is my Y bar. Still to calculate.
You can take it as 45.
This is?
Not the other one.
One second. I'll just increase the volume.
Ma'am, the other first value you can take it as 40.9, right?
40.98 it is.
No, ma'am, we can take 40.9.
40.9, why you want to take? Take 41. Somehow, see, 40.5, no, it is in between. Either it will not be 40 or... Why I rounded off, it will be 41 is better. Because somehow we have to take the difference and we have to square it. So that time this contribution will be not that much counted. Huh?
Okay.
And, okay. Now take it now. We need to construct a table. Can anybody help me in writing? First, we want the value of x. How to take x?
X minus x bar.
X minus x bar. Y can be taken as y minus y bar. Correct? What else is required?
Summation of x bar.
No, summation will come later on. Only x, y. We want a x square.
Yeah.
We want a y square. Yeah. Let us construct this table. What is my first entry here? See, capital X is small x minus x bar. That means you have to take first entry in this x minus x bar. Means 25 minus 41 is the first entry for capital X. Are you getting it? What is 25 minus 41? How much?
Minus 16.
Minus 16. Okay. Next, 43 minus 41.
2, ma'am.
2. Like this, go on taking for each value. So how many values of x and y you will get now? 8 set of values, right? 27 minus 41 is how much?
Minus 14.
Minus 14. Likewise, go on taking the next.
Minus 6.
One of you just helped me in writing minus 6. Next.
13.
13. Next.
20.
Huh? 20?
20.
20.
Next.
Minus 4. Minus
4, huh? 4. And then 4.
Plus 4. Then?
No, minus 4 and then? Plus
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, yes. We have a minus 4 as well as plus 4, no? Yes.
Yes.
37 and 45, yes. Yeah.
Ma'am, summation x is minus 1.
How much you said? Summation x?
Minus 1.
Minus 1.
Okay, one second. X is not required. Simply you add it. In the formula, we don't have summation x. Or do you have it? No, no. Why unnecessary extra? Don't add x and y. Yeah, tell me now why. Why similar way? So, but you have to take now y bar. See? 35 minus 40.5.
Minus
5.5. Next. 5. Next.
6.5.
Next.
6.5, ma'am.
Again,
ma'am, minus 20.5. No, ma'am.
Minus
20.5.
Next.
Minus 3.5. Ma'am, next 22.5. Ma'am, then 13.5. Minus 12.5. Minus 0.5.
Hope all are getting the same value. Again, don't add y, huh? It's not required. Now multiply x, y and take it. Minus 16 into minus 5.5 is how much? Yeah, one of you just dictate the values.
10.5.
13,
ma'am, next.
Ma'am, first one 88, ma'am.
First one 88.
First one 88. Second one 130, ma'am.
130. Double of 6.5 is 13.
No, ma'am. 13 only.
That is correct. Tell me next.
287.
Next. 21. for
290 next and then 2 ma'am.
It minus 2 ma'am.
Where the values of x and tell me
456 ma'am 4 196 36 169 400 1616
Tell me now y square minus 5.25 6.5 the whole square
20.25
Next
12.25
next
0.25
okay. What are the columns to be added up? Only xy, x square and y square, that's all. Yeah. Add it and tell summation x y
1019.5
okay summation x square
1093
okay
next one is 1350
1350 that's all Yes. So these are the values by adding these columns xy, x square, y square, what we are getting. Okay. So let us calculate the rank correlation coefficient. So rank correlation coefficient, how it is denoted? Don't change the notation. How it is denoted? R.
Small.
How it is given by small r. Yes. Summation of, yeah, tell me the formula, xy divided by root of summation x square into summation y square. You need to substitute and then finalize. Don't write the value directly. So what is summation xy? 1019.5 divided by under the root. Summation x square is 1093 into 1350. Yeah, simplify and tell me the answer.
0.8392.
Roughly, can you tell your answer is correct? Yes, ma'am. Yeah, because this value is
yes. Minus one or
plus yeah, between minus between one minus plus minus one. So your answer is roughly right. If you get something like 1 point, 2 point, please don't end up with the answer. Go back and check the answer. See, this happens even in probability note. The value is always between 0 to 1. Students forget. They get the value as some probability value as 200 or something like that. Correlation coefficient never exceeds 1, plus 1. Okay, remember this. Is the part clear? Is the example clear? Isn't it simple concept? Tell me overall. Isn't it a simple concept? From this part, you will get surely one question. Surely one question will come. Any doubts are there? Can ask. Only this table, the X and Y values, they change. Other part of the question will be almost same. Okay. Let me give one example then.